This video is to help you visualize the front, top, and right side view of the objects in exercise 2.3. On the screen is the first one. So let's look at the front view. Let's look at a top. Back to the front. And then to the right. So you can see we're dealing with a lot of cylindrical shapes here. And when you begin this sketch, the corner that you normally begin a square sketch from would be right in this area here. It would be tangent to this bottom quadrant and tangent to this quadrant if it came down. So to locate the center of these circles that you'll see in the front view, you'll count from that corner on your grid sheet over half the diameter and then up half the diameter. That's where you would put a center mark. So quickly we'll go top, back to front, over to right, back to front, back to the ISO. Here's the second one. Now this one's a little trickier. We've got a cylinder that's been cut in half, gives us these half round shapes. So let's look at the front view. Front, top, front, and then over to the right side. Back to the front, and then to the isometric view. The third one, a little more complicated. Let's look at the front view. Go to the top, back to the front, then to the right. I think that this should be a hidden line right here. It's showing up as a visible line, that line right there. Let's go back and look at that. Yeah, that's going to be a hidden line across there when we look at that in the right side view. So that should be showing up as a hidden line. It's just this 3D modeler that I'm using. So here's the isometric view. This is the fourth model. Let's look at the front view. And on this one, I think you'll see where these arcs come around on each end. We call this shape a stadium. The center of those arcs should be in here someplace. So you're going to draw a center mark here and extend out past the edges of the arc. So there will be a center mark over here about where the center of this arc would be. So there's the front. There's the top. These will not show up as visible lines. It's just that on this modeler, they're showing up as tangent, what we call tangent edges. Here is the right side view. Now remember, you will need a center line to go through here to represent the center of that hole. Let's go back to home. So front, top, back to front. So actually where this line here on the edge is showing up, you're going to have a center line running through right there. Let's go back to the home view. The fifth model, front. So you're going to have a center mark for this arc, but that center mark is also the center for this arc. So those are concentric, and you'll have one over here on the opposite side. So front view, top, back to front, then to the right side view, back to front, top, back to front. Sorry, I don't think I got back to the front. There's the front, then to the right, back to front, and then back to the isometric view. The sixth object, these are the ones that resemble architectural models. Front view, top view, front view, right side view, front view. Now the one that's tricky here is this hidden line that you see across here is actually coming from the edge that runs across behind that. So when I turn it, if you watch where that hidden line comes from, and then back to the isometric view. Here is the seventh model, also one that resembles a house. Front view. So up in this house, there's no hollow walls. These are solids. And then we have windows that go all the way through those solids. So front, top, front, right side view. So of course, this is an inclined plane here. This is an inclined plane here. And we go to the top view, we see that all of these are inclined planes in the top view. So here's this cutout for what's supposed to be our door, but it actually just goes all the way through the house. Back to the front view and then to the isometric view. Here is the eighth model. Front view. Top view. Back to front. Then to the right side view. Back to the front view. And this hidden line we have coming across here, when we turn it to the right, we can see it's the top of this cutout that goes all the way across. So let's go back to the top view and back to the front and then back to our ISO. The ninth model, for some reason, came in very small. So here is the front view. Here is a top. We'll go back to the front and then over to the right. So let's go back to the front and see where those hidden lines are coming from. So we have this square cut that runs all the way through. And when we go to the right, you can see where it goes all the way through right here. And we're seeing the top of this arc, excuse me, when we go over here, that's top of the arc. And then we see the top of that cutout as it goes through. So we're in the front view. There is the top. And this line here, that's should be a hidden line that's coming across here. If we go back, so these models are good for visualizing where those planes would be. And then you have to sort of decide, well, is that plane going to be hidden or visible? What's that feature going to be? So we're back to the front view. And there is the isometric view.